Hi there, thanks for tuning in to Dear Cyber Sue today. I have a question from Carrie. Carrie says, how do I move on from my partner who treats me badly? Some days I'm so strong and then other days I'm a mess and go back to him. Despite knowing he's not good for me. We don't live together, but we do have been together for a couple of years. What should I do? Okay, so I guess what the first question I would have for you, what triggers you to have strong days and what triggers you to have these sort of days where you feel a little more clingy that you want to go back to him? These are things you have to start analyzing within yourself. What keeps you in that really strong part of your self-esteem where you can say to him, now, I deserve better than this. I've got boundaries. I'm not going to be sitting there going back to a guy who treats me badly. Because those are the things you have to hold on to. Write those things down. Whatever it is at the time that you feel that way, write that down and make sure that you practice that regularly. When you're having days where you're feeling maybe a little more insecure, something happened at work, something happened in your family, whatever the situation is, write those down too, because those are the times that you really want to block him or do whatever you can. Now, I know that you divulged a little bit more to me than I read out here. So I know that it's a little bit more on a toxic kind of scenario here. And when somebody is talking down to you, they ridicule you, they're calling you names, they tell you that you're not good enough and that all these horrible things about you, and you get mad at yourself because you go back to them knowing this is wrong. So what are you supposed to do? How do you get to your self-esteem place of feeling good, like when you have those days where you say, I'm not gonna even answer them back today? You have to do more of those days. I know that sounds really simple and I'm just sitting here not living your world, so who am I to say that it's that easy? I'm not saying it's that easy. I'm saying there's ways for you to start paying attention to when you have those strong moments. There's something inside of you that's probably happened at an earlier stage in your life that's caused trauma to you or some drama in your life that's stuck. It's sitting in there and it's taking hold of whenever you feel like somebody doesn't want you or doesn't want to be with you or they're talking mean to you and you want to pull them in to let them know that you're okay and you're a good person. So it's like you've got something to prove to them. But forget about them. They know how to play you. There's men and women out there that are really good manipulators. They know how to do this to people. They choose you because maybe you're not strong enough at the time when they meet you. They see a vulnerability in you. So you're kind of like on their watch, you know? And the stronger that you get and the more you mean what you say every time you have those strong moments with them, the more that they will pull away from you. Another thing I would like to suggest is that you don't allow yourself to be around friends or family that treat you this way as well. Because sometimes this is a learned behavior from so long ago and you don't even notice that it's kind of taking over your life and that it's coming into your love world and your relationships. It's bad enough that you have to have it from a long time ago in your past and then now bring it into what you want to be your future. So what I really suggest you do here is pay attention to who you've allowed in your life as well as your partner. Are these people there for the right reasons in your life? Are they there to be really kind and loving to you? Is it a give and take friendship or partnership in your family? When I say partnership in a family, you know, that's what it is. If you're seeing your family a lot, you've got a lot of stuff going on with them. There's a lot of influence happening. So you want people in your life that are giving to you, you're giving to them. It's very reciprocated. There's no drama, there's no BS. There's stuff that flows really nice together. They are happy for you, they don't use you, and you're not using them. But I think in this case, you are feeling moments of strength that are really in there with you, and then you've got this stuff that comes back. It just comes flushing back up again, and you feel this insecurity, and so you want to glom onto this person. So the more that you can put yourself into situations with people that are wonderful, warm, loving, they're not using you, that will help you choose the right partnerships in relationships as well. So take baby steps. I know it's not going to be easy for you. I would really suggest that you find a therapist or maybe a psychologist that deals with trauma or toxic sort of childhood issues, things like that, that maybe has been in there for such a long time. You got to get those cobwebs that are mixed up and get them out of there, because I really believe that because you know it's wrong for you, but you keep going back, there's something there that is it's just something that you're so used to and it's familiar that you keep going back because it's kind of a comfort, even though ultimately it's not, but it's familiar to you. And as I've mentioned in other videos, familiar isn't always a good thing. If you're repeating something over and over again that's not working for you, and you've got all your friends and everybody like wanting to just like strangle you because you keep doing a repetitive thing, you really have to take the next step and a better step for you, because this is not healthy. And the fact that you've written me with about it, and a lot of other people have too, I've had guys write me about this, it's time to really do some homework here. Figure out what isn't working and what you can do to make it better. And those strong days you have, get more of those. Because you know that's where you're supposed to be. You're not supposed to be going back to the other side that goes, oh, okay, you know, I'll let him back again. We see, he said some really sweet things to me today. Oh, maybe he's not so bad. Quit giving him so much benefit of the doubt. You've been together for a long time. You're not living together. There's no commitment. What do you owe him? You don't owe him anything. So baby steps. Hang on to the strong moments. Put yourself into places with really good people that are strong for you. And please see somebody that can maybe get to like the bottom of what's going on. Maybe a hypnotherapist. I'm not a psychologist. I don't know all these things, but I will say they do help with something that's really stuck. Let's offer some suggestions to help you out here. Thanks everyone for listening to Cyber City today. See you later. Bye.